This tutorial's purpose is to help you get started using GroundsKeeper Pro by introducing the important concepts and processes of the software. This tutorial will focus on one example of a typical operating scenario for a lawn care and landscaping service business. This operating scenario is just one example of how your business may be run. We understand that there are many different ways to manage your business. GroundsKeeper Pro is flexible enough to handle almost any business operating scenario. The first order of business when beginning to use GroundsKeeper Pro is to enter all of your customers' information, such as billing addresses, job site addresses, services, and service prices. This is the initial software setup and only needs to be performed once. This is the most time-consuming process of getting started, but once the information is entered, you may begin using the software to its full extent. If your customer already has a balance, you will want to make an entry into their account that states their starting balance. If it's a new customer or the beginning of a new season, and the customer has a zero starting balance, you can move directly on to creating schedules. Services are not required to be scheduled, but if you want the software to remind you when a service needs to be done, you will definitely want to utilize this feature. Let's schedule the lawn maintenance service every 7 days for your entire season, which for our example runs from mid-March to mid-November. Your actual season may be longer or shorter. The resulting schedule is shown here. Once all of your customers' services have been scheduled in this way, you are ready to see how easy it is to run your business on a daily basis. Typically, you only need to set up your service schedules once a season, unless new services or customers are added during the season. The daily routine will be to view your daily schedule to see what jobs need to be done. If you have crews or workers, you may want to divide the day's jobs up and assign them to their associated worker or crew's route. The route names would correspond to the name of the worker or crew. Now it's time to print the schedule or route and go out into the field to perform the services. At the end of the day, you will come back to the office and reschedule the services you didn't get to and charge for the services that were completed. Other daily tasks might also include creating estimates for potential customers, recording customer interactions, recording chemical applications, if your state requires it, entering any payments received, and entering any expenses incurred. We are assuming for this tutorial that you want to bill on a monthly basis. However, you can have any date range for your billing. This means you could bill for a single day or several months at a time if desired. The billing cycle is determined by the start date and the end date entered. The bills were designed to be used with window envelopes, including a companion envelope your customer uses to return payment. Another optional monthly routine would be to run the determined late paying customers routine and add an optional late fee to customers who are flagged as not paying on time. These simple daily and monthly routines are run throughout the service season. Let's imagine now that the previous year's season is over and it's time to start a new year's season. It's a good idea to start your new season off by archiving last year's data and then running the software's cleanup procedure. This is an option since the software can hold many years of data. However, we do recommend archiving and cleaning up your data yearly to minimize the number of records you will need to scroll through and maximize the speed of the software. In essence, the cleanup process simply wipes the slate clean to begin a new year. If you need to look at a previous year's data, you would simply restore the data back in. The cleanup procedure will remove only the records you specify and leave all customers' billing addresses, job sites, and services. Just before your new season begins, you will most likely want to send out renewal letters to your current customers to see what services they want to sign up for in the upcoming season. In GroundsKeeper Pro, This is called the service contract. As you get your customer responses back, you will want to schedule the services they sign up for. Just like last season, you will schedule all these services for the upcoming season. After all customer services have been scheduled, you are ready to begin your daily and monthly routines again, just like last year. This simple yearly cycle will repeat for each year and season. If your company's operating scenario does not match this tutorials, don't assume GroundsKeeper Pro won't work for you. GroundsKeeper Pro is very flexible and can handle almost any operating scenario. As you can see, GroundsKeeper Pro is very easy to use once you understand the important concepts. So what are you waiting for? Get started using GroundsKeeper Pro today. To get more detailed information on GroundsKeeper Pro features, simply preview the other available tutorials for this product.